Mr. D at In the Middle with Mr. D1 at blogspot.com with some more teaching tips for lesson three of my sight singing program S Cubed, available on Teachers Pay Teachers at Music in the Middle with Mr. D. Now, we've probably been doing ear training exercises now from anywhere from 3 days to 5 days, or maybe even longer, 10 to 15 minutes per day. We've been playing the game, Forbidden Pattern, from lesson one. We've been doing Follow the Hand. In the game, we are continuing to use do-ti, do-ti do, do-ti la, because we're going to try to push them underneath do very soon in preparation. That's what the game's going to do for us. We're picking patterns that include do and ti. Then in Follow the Hand, we're probably up to an octave by now. They can follow your hand at a very slow pace. They're showing the positions well. You've got your ladder behind you. You've got your bullseye behind you. And now we can do another exercise if your students are doing really, really well. This would be like lesson five, a listening exercise number five for advanced students. This is where you want to eventually go. So what I would do is to sing an ascending scale. Scales are awesome way to get ear training done once you've done listening exercises 1, 2, and 3, and 4 if you decided to do that. And I would go very obviously sharp on the ascending scale. And I would ask them to raise their hand when I'm finished and identify any notes that were out of tune. And I'd sing in their range.
Do, re, mi, fa, sol, la.
And that fa was obviously very out of tune on purpose. And that's typically where they do it. They'll raise their hand, they'll tell you. I would have finished the scale, but I just want you to have the gist here. Then I'd pick a different key, do the same thing, maybe pick a different pitch to be out of tune on, just make sure it's very obvious. Then when I do the same thing on the descending, well, our students normally go flat on descending scale because they make the steps too big. So I would do things that are typical. That wobbly T, I'd sing all the way down, but the rest would need to be very in tune. So make sure you can sing really, really in tune. These ear training exercises will help them a lot. And then if you don't feel like you can sing it in tune using the solfege syllables, then you maybe just use do, something very pure, clear, very easy for them to hear. The goal is success, and every time they're successful, they're eager for more. So you have to make it obvious, but you have to be very good at the singing it out of tune. And if you do miss one once in a while, and we do, just admit it and maybe use it as a teachable moment. Was I flat or sharp in that moment? So this is an advanced, more advanced exercise. And then when they sing the scale and they go out of tune, you get to ask, you know, you get to say to them, you heard me all those weeks that we've been doing this or days that we've been doing this, that I, when I'm sharp on fa, what are you doing? And it's kind of a little fun. They laugh and you can sing the way, once you've done exercises like this, you can sing something sharp or flat the way that they're doing in your classroom. And they laugh. I'm like, this is how you sound. Is that what you want? And then it's a great teaching tool. Their ears get better and better. It helps your choral literature. It helps everything in your classroom. So those are some ear training exercises from lesson 3 of S Cubed, available on Teachers Pay Teachers at Music in the Middle with Mr. D. Have a great day.